It's like, so that your faith will not rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. When the gospel is the word only, the faith of men will rest in your wisdom. Ah! But when people see the supernatural that follows, they will say, of a truth, of a truth, of a truth. Supernatural. Unveil the power that is in heat, because the gospel is the power. Go back to heart. So they arrested them. They said, don't preach the gospel. Don't preach this gospel again. Don't preach in this name again. We have told you. Don't talk about this name, man, Jesus. And Acts chapter 4 verse 23. I like what happened. After they had been filled with the Holy Spirit, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you know, the supernatural, they were just walking in it. They were just going for mass services, like they were just going to church. They were planning to heal the lame. They're like, Peter and John were not planning. They didn't set the miracle in mind. The Holy Spirit did not even tell them, now you're well, they're okay. They were just going. It was on a normal Sunday, we meet with rabbits. And they were just going to church. And then something just happened. Jesus, come and rest your feet and walk. That is how we are expected to flow in the supernatural. You don't need to go and pray. Imagine if Peter and John had to go and fast and pray 40 days. The lame and the beautiful gate. Power to heal. It's just consciousness. What we have. What we have. There's a man by the name of Bishop Betsy Dawosa. He had one message. Just one message in church. How Jesus entered the house of Jairus and raised the daughter of Jairus. That was the message he heard in church. And then after church, the man took his bike, his bicycle. In the neighborhood, looking, is there anybody dead here? Is there anybody dead here? They said, no. Is there any? And then he got to a place. Finally, he opened the scripture. How did Jesus do it? Jesus drove everybody in the room out. Everybody come out. Go out. And then Jesus, just as it was written in the scripture, you are too spiritual to walk in. You are too overly spiritual. You want to go on 40 days dry fasting for you to raise one dead. A man just heard one message, because faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Ha! And then he entered. And then that was how the first day. If you can do it once, you see, it becomes natural. The supernatural becomes natural. Hallelujah! One man, he had not been shot. He became a Bishop Benson that was there. He was just a normal Christian. Hallelujah! And Acts 4:23. I like what they did. I'm being let go, Peter and John. After they let them go, they went into their home company. The KJV says they went to their home company. Believers. God has not designed a believer to live in isolation. No matter how high up there you are, you need people around you. A lot of you are doing isolatory Christianity. But scripture says in Psalm chapter 68, I think verse 9 also, it said God sets the solitary in families. God sets the solitary in families. You don't have to do life alone. You have to belong to a company. So when we company like this, when we gather like this, it is for us to stir up the supernatural. That was why we did what we had to do before we started the message. A lot of us, we are too dependent on the man of God. You are always looking up to the man of God. You have shifted your grace from Christ Jesus, from the things he has asked you to do. They went to their home company. And they reported all that the chief priests and elders have said unto them. Every believer has to belong to a company. You have to belong to a company. Company of like-minded people. People who are thirsty and their hunger and their pants are for the same spiritual things that you have. The only people you have around you here, I foresee it like baby. I want to walk. You can't, you see, you cannot walk in the supernatural. A sharp rapper, that is the only people you have company with. They went to their home company. Who are you? Who are your own companions? I foresee it like baby. I didn't know what it was until I just, okay. I just said, what's, I foresee it like feet were levity. I choose my company. I choose my company. David said, I'll company with those who fear you, O Lord. Who are your friends? Who are your friends? Who are the people you run to when you're in trouble? Bible says, after the chief priests let them go, they went to their home companions. What? To stir up the supernatural. Now they just saw a tip of an iceberg. It was a layman that was healed. But yet, little did they know that aprons and handkerchiefs from the body of Peter, they begin to heal the sick and raise the dead. Okay, you understand the lame walk, Tabi? Let us gather and stay it more. You will see so much more. And not every miracle that will be undeniable. Thank you, Minister Femi, for that CIA awakening. I'm being let go. Being let go. They went. You cannot stay around me and be cold. When people tell me they are struggling spiritually, I don't. If I lay hands on you, you may. The contest may continue, but I will just tell you. When I'm praying in the morning, join me. If you see me pray in the afternoon, join me. If you see me pray in the evening, join me. Even if you are cold, you will become hot by force. Because that is the way it works in the kingdom. How you sharpen it high. So shall a man sharpen the countenance of one another. You come to God, you come to church, always, you know, you want to get high. You have made church an opium center. Let the man of God just preach me. The neighbor next to you can make you high. High on, sharpen it. I like to company with like-minded believers. People who are hungry and thirst for the right things. Not the company of people that will gossip. Have you heard what Peter did? Have you heard what John did? You know, 1,001 ways to keep a man. You know, how not to allow your husband to abuse you. How I almost broke my home. And people will gather on social media saying all manner of nonsense. And the devil is striving. And the devil is happy. Because he has distracted you from the most important things. Distractions up and down. You want to belong to this group because you know, my husband yesterday had to collect your money, had to collect money from your heart. Really? People have been married before Jesus came to die. So the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ is not just about you getting married. And no, excuse me. When a man is in Christ, he's the new creation. You think Jesus came to die and so that all you can do in your life is get married and have children? There is not to like than that. Your completeness is not in a man. Your completeness is not in a woman. Your completeness is not in a career. Bible says that ye are complete in him. In Christ Jesus. Your completeness is in Christ. When you're in Christ, every other thing gets settled. When you understand, when you're establishing your understanding of your identity in Christ, every other thing will be settled. So you're looking for completeness in a career, a man, a friend, people who don't have the same passion as you. The gospel is my ambition. If you see me and you want to catch up with me, you must be seeing the things I'm seeing. You must have the same focus. So you follow people that drag you down. I pour water on the fire that is on your inside. No, they just water you down every time. Must we always talk about Jesus every time? So we must always talk about. If there is no Jesus, there is no other discussion. There is no the only discussion. And it comes to because I'm crazy. The gospel is my ambition. Forget it. I am a professional in my field. But when it comes to the gospel, I can go crazy. I can go gaga. It is my ambition. So it chooses the kind of company I keep. Give me the next verse. They reported all the chief priests that said to them. So when they heard what the chief priests had done to them, Bible says they raised their voice to God. This is where our generation is getting it wrong. That when you report what the chief priests and elders have done to you, you scatter to talk about the fathers and dishonor them. They did not pray against the chief elders and the priests. They raised their voice to God. That God, they have seen the lame walk, but let the blind see. Not group of prayer warriors. See, when they heard that, they raised their voice to God, not against men. A lot of people are not walking in the supernatural. You know, you see a man of God, probably is not preaching the God true gospel, and then you gather, begin to talk about them, you argue, you disown them. This was not, we have not so learned Christ. We have not so, pick on him, but we have not so learned Christ. They threatened them. They forbid them. They told them not to preach in that name. But what did their company do? They raised their voice to God with one accord and said, Lord, you are God. We made heaven and the earth and the sea and all that is in them. For it was written, give me the next verse. And they began to pray the Psalm of David. Who by the mouth of your servant David have said, why did the nations rage? They gathered to pray the scriptures. They were not just gossiping. They were not in dishonor. They prayed, why do the nations rage? Or the kings desire a vain thing. And then, give me verse 30. Give me verse 30. No, 29. See the peak of their prayer. Now, Lord.